termini di tenenza che hai pagato tu?
One and all present here, it gives me immense pleasure to extend to you a warm welcome on behalf of VME Media School, who has clubbed all of us for the first lecture under BJ Verghese series of this semester on a very commonly asked yet important matter fetching intensely inquisitive minds of my fellow budding journalists, and the topic is what a journalist is. I, Tanushree Bhanot, on behalf of BME Media School, is honored and obliged with the gracious presence of our chief guest, Ms. Archana Datta. We welcome you, ma'am. We welcome our dignitaries, our vice chairman, Mr. Aman Sahani, sir, director officiating, Dr. Ravikant Swami, sir, Dean DME Media School, Dr. Amrish Saxena, sir, head of the department, Dr. Sushmita Bala, ma'am, faculty members, and all my dear friends. Before heading further, for seeking the blessings of Master Swati, I would like to invite our honourable director, I would like to invite Dean DME Media School and all the dignitaries to accompany our chief guest, Ms. Archana Datta ma'am, to kindle the lamp. Ma'am has played a key role as a media advisor with the Indian Information Services. She has also been press secretary to the President of India and has implemented outreach programs to highlight presidential initiatives and interventions. Whilst working with the Press Information Bureau, she has proactively launched public campaigns. On grassroots level, she has launched and implemented various programs concerning the socio-economic development. She is also renowned for her overall management of round-the-clock news operations in entire country as Director General in All India Radio and Doordarshan. With her remarkable oratory skills, ma'am has also worked as the spokesperson for the Union Ministry of Rural Development and Minority Affairs. Ma'am, we are honored to have you. Now, I would like to request Director Dr. Ravikant Swami, sir, to felicitate our guest. And now I request Dr. Sushmita Bala ma'am to address the gathering with her motivational words.
Special lecture series in this semester and the first in this new year as part of the BJ Verghese lecture series. On behalf of TVME Media School, I also welcome Mr. Aman Sahani sir, Vice Chairman of the DME, and Ravikant Swami sir, director of DME. I acknowledge their contribution to supporting such vital discourses. B.G. Verghese lecture series has been instituted in the name of the distinguished journalist B.G. Verghese, who is remembered for making a deep impact in Indian journalism. DME Media School organizes one special lecture every month as part of B.G. Verghese lecture series. Last year, we were privileged to listen to Mr. K.J. Suresh, Director General, IMC, Mr. N.K. Singh, Senior Journalist, Mr. Prashant Tandon, Senior Journalist, and Mr. Ujjwal Chaudhary, Senior Media Educator, Author, and Columnist. Last semester, we got the opportunity to listen to Mr. Anshuman Tiwari, Senior Journalist. Today, we would further get an insight in journalism as Mr. Archana Datta will be speaking on what a journalist is. Last time, Mr. Anshuman Tiwari spoke on the journalist in you. We are grateful, Ma'am Archana Datta, for accepting our request and speak on such a pertinent subject. I'm sure that the students and the teachers present here will be immensely benefited by her thoughts. I once again, Ma'am, at DME, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. And now I request Dr. Ravikant Swami sir to address the gathering.
The luminaries present on the stage and the would-be luminaries present off stage. Yes, all my dear students, you are would-be luminaries. Very soon we would be watching you on, I don't know, the small screen or the big screen, but I'm very sure I would be watching you there. Today we are starting again with the B.G. Verghese series in this semester. I believe most of you were born in the 90s, right? Yes, it was during the 80s when the organization to which our today's speaker belongs, it ruled the country. Yes, it was during the 80s that the roads used to be vacant when Mahabharata used to be aired, when Ramayana used to be aired. So for this coveted lecture series, who else other than a person belonging to Doordarshan can be the speaker? So let us welcome the relevance of Ma'am Archana Datta as the speaker on this occasion. I don't know how many of you remember the names of TV serials like Buniyad, Ye Jo Hai Jindagi, Tamas. Do you remember? Well, those were the serials with which people like me were brought up, and I must say that, ma'am, the serials produced by Doordarshan. Yeah, Hum Log. That was another very popular serial. So those were the days when the foundation of television was laid down in this country. And yes, I am proud to say that Dr. Amrish and Ma'am Bala has brought in a speaker who was instrumental in laying the foundation of television in this area. Well, students, this lecture series has got a specific objective, and the objective is amalgamating what you are studying within the four walls of the classroom with what is practiced. I am very sure it's going to be an enlightening lecture. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I would like to call Dr. Amrish Saxena, sir, to share his thoughts and enlighten us.
Archana Datta, ma'am, other dignitaries, and teachers and students. This is part of this B.G. Verghese series, wherein we try to bring it, bring all such good people to talk to you, to interact with you, who matters, and who have done something very significant towards media. So I will not speak much because we are here to listen to Archana Datta ma'am. On journalism, particularly, last lecture was also, before that, I think in August lecture, that was on journalism also, when Anshuman Tiwari spoke at length on journalism. Again, we have the opportunity wherein Archana Datta ma'am will be speaking on different facets of journalism, which is definitely very, very vital, very necessary for all of us to understand, and particularly those who might be practicing journalism after completing their BGMC program. We are also using this occasion to release the three books which have been published as an outcome of the international conference that we held very recently, I can too. So these three books which were taken out by the publisher, carrying all the papers which were presented in the conference, so that release of that will happen. Also, we will use this opportunity to formally announce the International Film Festival that we are going to organize in April. Also, I believe the film that was recently made by you people only on Me Too, wherein Archana Datta ma'am was also one of the contributors, he spoke in that. So that is also to be screened. So that is all. This is something, this whole function is something wherein everybody, there is something of everybody's interest and everybody is to be benefited by that. Thank you all.
I request technical team to kindly do the screening of Me Too documentary.
The building, it's impressive, front side, your faculty members, the infrastructure, everything is so impressive. So I would like to stress upon that you are lucky to be part of this institute. I must congratulate all of them for many things. Number one, for making this film. You know, I myself wanted to come to this institute because a group of students of this school visited my house and interviewed me. I said thereafter, Mr. Saxena, that you know, I must come to this institute. When are you inviting me? Then about a month back, he sent an invitation that such and such thing is happening. Okay, so I am here. And for the book as well, and giving me this wonderful opportunity. I have prepared something in writing, you know, which is already with Mrs. Bala. I mean, that can be circulated to you. You can read it. I must compliment this institute for instituting this lecture in the name of Digi Verghese. Why? You know, a few days back, I was reading one of the mainline English newspaper. This is a story about Gujarat encounter, in which, I mean, that's the mainline newspaper, everybody reads it. I was shocked to see the reporter is writing in the story, one Mr. B.G. Verghese, who filed an PIL in this connection. So I was aghast and shocked, and so was many of my media friends. Then I seen a Facebook post by somebody that, what is today's journalism? You know, they don't know who is Mr. B.G. Verghese, an iconic name in the sphere of journalism. So that time it struck me, there is an institution which has instituted the name of, in his name, a lecture series where people will invariably take his name, bring out the qualities that he stood for, and you will be all aware the yardstick set by Mr. B.G. Verghese is worthy of emulation for many, many decades to go. So at least this name will strike in your name, not like that journalist, you know, who very casually in passing mentioned about B.G. Verghese. So that really shocked me, you know, and that has reiterated why I have chosen this topic. What a journalist is. We are all suffering an identity crisis. What a journalist is. What for his existence? What for he finds the story? And Amrish ji, aap bhi media group ke hai, media minds mein. A few days back, Ujjal has written an article in which my colleague Esther has commented that, you know, how can, you know, business and editorial go together, like if the business conglomerate has, stick in news operation? Very pertinent questions. So all these things are putting media under tremendous pressure, focus, what we are supposed to do. I mean, you are all the budding journalists of tomorrow. You will be joining your vocation, but what should be the priorities? So I thought of writing down a few points and bring it to, most of them are questions which will make you think. And Mr. B.G. Verghese, we are, for being part of AIR and Doordarshan, every day we used to discuss about Mr. Verghese committee report, which sadly not implemented. Though, you know, that was the autonomous bodies, both of radio as well as Doordarshan. But what he thought of, you know, constitutional safeguards as an independent estate, you know, like the fourth pillars of democracy, that has not yet happened. You know, I, being an insider, I have no hesitation in admitting that we are far from that, the goal that was set. The other was Assembly Trader Committee. It has not yet been implemented. So we are far away to go. And I told Dr. Bala that I will be speaking for 45 minutes because I go to different media institutions. I have seen attention is very precious. You get restless after some time. So I'll be speaking, say now it's already late, for about 20-25 minutes. Thereafter I'll be open to question, because one of the important criteria of being journalist is your inquisitiveness. You must be asking questions to go to the depth. So the topic is today what a journalist is, because to me there is a you know, overwhelming identity crisis that we are facing as media in general and print media everywhere. You know, what is our goal, what for we are striving, and what for you are pursuing your education? There must be some aim, goal or something. So but who will operate this? You know, that one quote really struck me a few days back. That was Mr. Rajnath Singh, what he spoke in Arun Goenka Memorial Lecture, another stalwart in the field of journalism. The quote is, media should show direct to the power, okay? But it should show no colors. What does it mean? Don't mix news with ideology. There is a separate space for views in a newspaper. Okay. The other day I saw a newspaper ad, you know, that this particular channel, I don't want to name it, that says that there is nothing between you and the truth. So anchorless news presentation. Our credibility is really at stake. I mean, news anchors are acting as hindrance rather than facilitator. So I like this quote. Think of it, whether we are really, media is showing the mirror to the power. Is it so? I mean, the question is open. Next, please. And what do you think about a journalist is? What is the popular notion prevails amongst us? What do you know about a journalist? I mean, during our childhood, we used to open a newspaper and we used to know many things. The person who opens the world to us far and near. What's happening in America, we come to know through newspaper. Now, though, I mean, throughout the day, you keep seeing news pouring in on your apps, isn't it? Everybody is having mobile set? You keep seeing? What do you see? That is the question. What do you see? You know, some say that we keep ourselves updated with the latest news. Very good. I mean, one should be updated with the knowledge what is happening around you. But this is the general idea that journalist opens the door of knowledge before us. And whatever events happening around us, we came to know through the writings or maybe the presentation of the news anchor. And the editorials are more important to many. Like, complicated issues are being simplified in editorials, a viewpoint being justified or condemned, whatever. You know, this is the common notion we understand. And the person could be anyone, a photojournalist, an editor, a news presenter. It could be, any format, or a news anchor, freelance writer, feature writer, could be anything. Any question? Do you agree? Are you brought up with this kind of, ideas that journalist is the person who keeps open the doors of knowledge, various things to you, happening around you? So this is the common knowledge. Yeah. Next, please. Now the question is, that is where I have my problem. Is a journalist a dispassionate news presenter? Should you be not attached to the idea that you are presenting? or simply presenting the facts as it is. No interpretation. I mean, is he the truth finder? What do you think? What a journalist is? Is he a truth finder? I mean, he's after the truth? Yes? You agree with me? Yeah, of course. I mean, he goes to the bottom of the fact, you know, digging out like many investigative journalists that they are doing and bringing to the fore various issues. Or is he an activist? Fighting for a cause? Somebody says yes. I mean, an activist laying bare the certain issues that needs wider discussion. You have to judge whether it's a right, and if it is wrong, pointing out to the authorities that it is wrong, it needs to be corrected. Okay, like the film, very well made film, Me Too. You are bringing out an issue and that it needs immediate attention. And as it is said, a committee is going to be formed to look into the various aspects of it. So, or is he entitled to give value judgment? What is the answer? Yes. But there are two different things. Presenting the facts, giving value judgment, is you have another forum for that. You can give your judgment, you can give your opinion, you can condemn or you can appreciate, but perhaps not while presenting news and current affairs. As Dr. Swami, he was pointing out, I was dealing with her news and current affairs, not the TV serials. So we were always facing a dilemma. What to say, what not to say, what government is saying, what private media is saying, which part we can take, which part we should, you know, put it in a nice language. So that dilemma we all faced in the newsrooms. The second, are they bound by any social responsibility, accountability to the society? Yes? All of you agree? Yes? Okay. So these are certain things that came to my mind, that perhaps a journalist is associated with Mr. B.G. Verghese, who espoused the cause of ethical journalism stood for. And he is a kind of torchbearer. And we always remember, while setting a standard, setting a mark, you know, that we should follow up. Next, please. And India is a democracy. I mean, that gives a special role to the journalist, isn't it? What the media is called? That's good. So you have a defined role. And what is that role? Is to facilitate free flow of information, isn't it? Because that helps you subsequently, you know, to make the informed choice. Now the election is coming, 2019. You have to make the informed choice which one you are going to vote for the next 5 years. Unless you know the issues, unless you make people aware, you know, these are the issues, these are the, you know, agenda that before the election, these were the priorities set, how much the present government could meet, what are the hopes being given by other parties, you know, is this possible? To help people to know the facts that will enable them to make the correct choice. So you have a role. And a watchdog of the society? Yes. It's called the watchdog of the society. And then lastly, in which we were very much part of it, like several programs of socio-economic development, governments formulate. And this program will remain only as a piece of paper unless people participate in it. So what you have to do, you have to tell people about this, these are the program meant for you, you come and participate, you enjoy the benefits of development. Various, you know, our country which needs people in certain areas special attention, and the programs are meant for them. So this is for motivating people. So development communication, is it being taught here? So development journalism developed, you know, to convey this kind of ideas, motivate, persuade people to join the mainstream of development. This is a special role. I don't know many, there are many names in development journalism who did wonderful work. But these are considered as the not as priority areas, maybe crime reporting, political reporting, that goes on the top. Next, please. Yes, I'll finish up quickly, but I want questions from all of you. You question me, whatever you say, it's not correct. Now, what has happened now? Why we were all worried, like Mr. Ambarishji also worried, being your teacher. What kind of values we are going to impart and how we are going to face the present media? What has happened? Yes. So I will tell you one by one. Like technology, that has brought in irreversible changes in our life. Everybody is now holding a mobile, isn't it? That opens the world. You are, you know, there is a disease called, you know, that the fear of losing your mobile, say, cell phone. Isn't it? So we feel helpless without our cell. What has happened to me, you know, if I don't see the message or, I mean, whatever, your communication. But it's a good thing, you want to remain connected. So same way in the news area, in current affairs, everything, and in the world of media, satellite technology, it has done irreversible changes the way now media operates. So we all agree. But what has happened that to the content, news content? Has it made deeper impact? Is it adverse? Is it beneficial? Let's see. Of course it's beneficial, but, you know, there is a but. The content has been cosmetically improved. Now you see the colored copies of newspaper, multiple versions. What all? Or there are many things, you know, which we have never seen. Reporting has become faster. You can reach any part of the country, you know, faster means, I mean, from remote corners of our country, reporting are coming, which was earlier it used to be difficult. Okay. So, I mean, yeah, better get a... But what about the inherent quality of the content? Has it changed? What are you talking? I won't take much time. Remember B.G. Verghese. You know, the type of reporting, the type, the standard he set of ethical journalism. So you were, I mean, discussing, you are listening, what are the values? It will be, I mean, immensely helpful in your profession. Yes, journalistic freedom and accountability. The other day I was hearing some, I mean, everybody must have noticed that news that CBI Special Court has convicted Dera Ram Rahim, you know, for killing a journalist. And then it brought to my mind that, you know, the rate of conviction is very poor. Like, you know, in the Me Too film, the rate of conviction of such kind of complaints are very rare and very few. That has something to do with our process. I mean, that's applicable for any issue. Okay. Next, please. Has journalistic ethics taken a backseat? What for? We all know Ramnath Goenka, B.G. Verghese. You know, ethics of journalism, where does it stand now? News has turned competitive, like everything else. What is scarce community? Your attention. How to get readers' attention, viewers' attention? How to get it? That's worrying the media houses. For TRP, for more ads, things like that. So kya karna hai? You know, then we have to make it sellable, you know, to grab your eyeball or attention. इसके लिए इसको क्या करना चाहता स्पाइस मिलाना है यू हैव टू स्पाइस इट अप एंड दैट इज क्रिएटिंग व्हाट सैड फेनोमेना ऑफ फेक न्यूज डू यू एग्री अमृष्टि अब इतने से न्यूज है ना कि अब कौन सा सच है कौन सा ये बिकॉज आई मीन इट इज फ्लडेड विद ऑल काइंड ऑफ स्टोरीज फेक न्यूज हैज बिकम सच अ प्रॉब्लम इन इंडिया लाइक एल्सवेयर बट इट इज क्रिएटिंग हैवॉक इन इंडिया Like, you know, the other day I was reading a story in one of the anchor story in Indian Express where, you know, how the village in Maharashtra has changed. They are no longer worried in the night, you know, they are chatting and talking. There is no rumor of child lifting. Child lifting or cow slaughter, maybe any number of issues, you know, that is unnecessarily being spread. And that's where more responsible are WhatsApp messages and some restriction have been imposed. Why? Because its market is flooded with news. You don't know. Gullible people are thinking, you know, this is true. And succumbing to the all kinds of pressure. And views also, hard news is disappearing. All kinds of sensationalism is ruling the roost. Views coming in the, this is another danger, views coming in the garb of news. Why the necessity of anchorless news? Because some people would like to know only the bare facts, not editorializing it, you know, giving your viewpoints, where you really could find the what is really happening. That is worrying all of us. Next, please. Yeah, and who are managing? That's why, I mean, there was a kind of discussion on a WhatsApp media platform ki who are managing the media show now because technology has made it competitive, more money is required, who have all the money, business houses, so they are now running media houses, so for them it's a business, okay, we have to promote your business and running the business means you have to earn profit, so news is a commodity, you have to sell it, and for selling you are doing all kind of tactics, so that's where the problem lies. Who are now on the management boards of media houses? Who are there? Investment bankers, corporate lawyers, venture capitalists, who all? Where is the poor media person? Where is the poor journalist? Where is the editor? Does he have any say? That's the question. Perhaps it's really there is a presence of an editor. Somebody arguing that business is different, editorial section is different, but in reality it's not happening. News outlets are promoting business, and what does that lead to? Paid news ke baare mein sune ho? Aap logon ne? Bade honge? News are advertorials. Ujjal Chaudhary in his article has given some way out. Kaise integrated newsroom hoga, you know, where all the platforms merge together. And that could be a viable medium of selling the news. Okay, I beg to disagree. So paid news phenomena, mostly in India in the context of elections, we came to hear about it. Paid news, because many political parties, I don't want to name, they are, whatever they want to sell, they want to bring it to the notice, knowledge of the readers that they have done such wonderful work, which may not be true. So paid news is a big phenomenon. Many cases are going on in courts. Conviction, I don't know, I'm not aware of it, because every legal process is time consuming. It takes its own time. Next please. How much now a journalist is an independent player? If you are bound from all sides, where are your hands? Somebody has commented the other day, a big journalist, after seeing my article in one of the leading dailies, that we remember you, means me, more as All India Radio Director General than in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. There I commented, in Rashtrapati Bhavan my hands were tied, I could move neither right nor left. So, mujhe jo कहा जाता था वही मैं करती थी. I mean the same way. A journalist is now bound by several factors, several constraints, what to say, what not to say, and how to say. That's most important. How to say it. So, you know, another prominent journalist I was going through before doing this few points, I did some research. One eminent journalist, can I take the name? Mr. Raman. He said that, yeah, they are like clerical coolies working on those content in which the management is a financial stake. The rest are not welcome. You promote certain story, play it up and play down certain stories. Don't make it come up, you know, don't get it people's attention or so they are not acting as mirror to the power. So journalistic freedom is now a greatest casualty, because you have to promote, you have to see the interest, whatever is being said. You may disagree with me, no, it's not happening, but unfortunately I corroborated with many of my journalist friends, yes, they are acting under certain constraints. So, I mean, they didn't want to elaborate, but such is the state of affairs. Another danger of monopolization of news media, media houses, a particular media house now running different platforms. So that created a kind of control on news dissemination, creation, they are creating such news which they want to, I mean, because they have every control over the different platforms, and that news is only spread because of the monopoly. That's another danger. So it is being dubbed as information imperialism, where you are not allowing free flow of information. You are discarding the duty allocated to you by the democracy. So we hear many kind of imperialism. This is another threat to the free flow of information, where information is being curbed and information is being disseminated the way you want, not as what it is. Isn't it a danger? Next, please. Sadly, news is now a commodity, like, you know, anything, any product, you name it, it's a product. So some of you, I mean, this school teaches BBA as well. So how to sell a product? That's a competitive, a spirit should be there. How best you can sell your product, how best you can place it before the consumers. So it's a kind of consumerism. You have to attract your potential buyers. How to attract it? So, you know, and you can see that newsmen, newspersons are being dubbed with various names. Like, I'm sorry to say, these I'm quoting, that's why I put single in budget comma, prostitutes, bazaaru, news traders, and very recently, pliable. The media took offense of the term being used, pliable. But sadly, that is being dubbed as like this, you know. We have lost, I mean, the profession of journalism has lost some prestige, you know, the value, the respect that journalism earned during the early decades, during independence. Imagine, the newspaper used to be the propagators of the spirit of patriotism. Like before coming to this lecture, you know, we were discussing how the lawyers of our country played an eminent role. Similarly, I will say the newspapers, you know, the various names, I can recall Amrit Bazaar Patrika. You know, this kind of, there are so many caseries, newspaper, you know, they were the avant-garde of spreading nationalistic views, patriotism. They have inspired the entire country. Where are they now? So, news is customized. So customized form of news, there are exceptions, but I'm just highlighting what are the aberrations so that you are aware of it, because the lecture is in the name of Mr. B.G. Verghese, so who was a kind of torchbearer, and we let us remember and let us taken a vow that we must follow the noble ideals that is set for us. So customized news is all engulfing us. And electronic media, kya kare, breaking news. Sahare hachi news is breaking news. I remember, you know, a poor father who has just lost his son in a mishap. All the channels, you know, with their mic, they're surrounding the poor father. They want a bite so that who will go ahead of other channel. So this kind of trivializations, you know, you are not understanding the gravity of the situation. He is not in a position, but you are making him to speak. This is very bad, you know. And other, like digital media, that is the craze of the day. Where is hate news, all kind of things, because that is very fast. It can catch fire in everyone within a second. So that is also being misused. And India is a country of such wide, large number of population. A single strike can add to a big fire. So this danger is really, you know, I mean, engulfing and approaching before us. We should all be careful. Okay, so I'm coming to the good news. Next, please. More bad news for journalism. I mean, that's a, I think, last but one. Where is India standing? It is now 136 in the World Press Freedom Index. Last year it was? This year it is 138, it was 136. Why? Because of large number of journalist harassment, killings. So what is the number? India's state has given a number, the 70 journalists killed between 1992 to 2016. 142 cases of attacks over a period of 2 years. Over a period of 2 years only. And there are numerous cases of unreported killing, harassment of journalists from our regional media or vernacular media. Only the prominent mainline English papers, you know, some gets noticed, rest are not. So, unfortunately, I also studied that those who journalists, you know, were being killed, what are the subjects they were covering, either RTI or politics or corruption issues, they are being the main primary targets of attack. Yeah, last. It's almost half an hour, yeah. Now, what is the good news? Social media has opened a new world all before us. We are all story writers. You can all contribute. And mainline newspapers, journalists, they are, or TV channels, they are contributing on social media. And target groups are also filing stories, giving response. So a new exchange is taking place. That's definitely a good news. So the process has become faster. Mutual exchange is going place. That's a good news for viewer or reader like us, like any one of you, and also who are the main story writers. It's a 24/7 exchange taking place. There are many citizens, reporters, bloggers coming up. Anything else which I have missed, like digital media has produced? Bloggers. Bloggers, many citizens, reporters also. I see regularly in one prominent English paper that what citizens are contributing, they're taking due notice, and also your response, what kind of 24/7 exchange is taking place. I had the occasion of attending a PR summit meeting. So PR professionals are there, say we are all worried now because 24/7 exchange, we are more worried about the digital platforms and their responses. Earlier, you know, we used to say either a single mail or something, you know, now we have to respond, we have to be always on the guard. So friends, these are the issues I brought to the fore, and you should be alert. And remember, there must be a course in ethical values in journalism in your class, in your the program. So, I mean, you have to revisit them, think about it, and remember the great stalwarts in the field of journalism. They have set standards. Let us follow them. And whatever may be the practical difficulties of today's journalism, but it can be easily get over, and we can again set a standard of ethical writing. You can really become a truth finder and activist if necessary. So a journalist, my answer to the question that I posed, what a journalist is. He's a combination of all. He's definitely a truth finder. He's an activist. He's a promoter, is a facilitator of free flow of information. It's a combination of all this. With this, I will, whatever I wanted to say, because again, attention is a sparse commodity now.
You see, that is also an indication we are just from here. Now I'm open to questions.
My English woman. तो हाँ, मेरा ये क्वेश्चन है कि जैसे कि आपने बताया कि पहले के सिनेरियो से आज के सिनेरियो में जर्नलिस्ट की पहचान काफ़ी बदल गई है, बट मैम स्टिल अमंग अस बहुत से ऐसे होंगे जो कि सिर्फ मास मीडिया के फील्ड में जाना चाहेंगे या फिर जो कि सिर्फ फीचर राइटिंग करना चाहेंगे, बट जैसे कि जर्नलिज्म में जो जाना चाहते हैं पर्टिकुलरली, तो मैम कई बार ऐसा भी तो होता है कि जर्नलिस्ट तो वो एकदम ट्रू एस्पायरेंट्स है, लाइक वो करेंगे बट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की वजह से वो दबते रह जाते हैं, तो मैम तब वो क्या करेंगे?
आपको अब क्या आपका सवाल ये है कि अगर जर्नलिस्ट तो करना चाहते हैं कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के वजह से वो दब जाते हैं, बोल नहीं पाते हैं। सो आजकल ये सिचुएशन तो हो गया कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन क्यों दबा देना चाहते हैं, क्या दबाना चाहते हैं? देयर मे बी मेनी जर्नलिस्ट यू नो हु डिफाई द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड राइट द स्टोरी, लेट देम रिजेक्ट योर स्टोरी। तो आपके सामने एक डिलेमा आएगा कि आपको करना क्या है। आप स्टोरी फाइल कर दोगे, आपकी स्टोरी अगर फाइल करोगे नो आपका एक बार वो पीछे चला जाएगा, लेकिन अगर आप उसको परस्यू करना चाहे तो आप कर सकते हो, आपके कॉन्शियंस को सुनना है ना, लेकिन ये हो नहीं रहा है। सो देयर इज अ ट्रेमेंडस प्रेशर ऑन अ जर्नलिस्ट, देयर इज नो अदर शॉर्टकट, यू नो यू हैव टू ओवरकम दैट प्रेशर and exert your freedom. आपके आप अकेले नहीं हो, आपकी तरह ऐसे बहुत सारे हैं। When it becomes a big voice, you know, then it will make a difference. So मैंने भी सारी इसके जवाब में ये है कि आपको प्रेशर में सकाम नहीं होना है। You will find your story, whatever the truth is.
हम apart from that मेरे रिलेशन में एक रिपोर्टर ही थे, like उनकी स्टोरीज होती थी, तो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में जैसे वो स्टोरीज आगे देते थे स्टोरीज, एकदम प्रॉब्लम ही होती थी, बाईलाइन की काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम होती थी, लाइक वो
बाईलाइन की
यस मैम, तो क्या होता था कि मैम सपोज वो स्टोरीज आगे भेजता था बट मैम उसमें थोड़ी बहुत मैनिपुलेशन, थोड़ी बहुत एडिटिंग होकर उसको प्रेजेंट किया जाता था एंड उसका नेम ही नहीं आता था, ना नी द कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट, नी द एडिटर, नी द रिपोर्टर, किसी भी एंगल से नहीं, एकदम इसका क्या किया,
मतलब बाईलाइन उनको नहीं दिया जाता?
नो मैम।
अच्छा,
एक्चुअली मैं some circumstances he committed suicide, so he is no more now, but उसके साथ ही problem काफी था।
Byline नहीं दिया जाता।
Yes ma'am, actually he was a tremendous writer.
This is another kind of exploitation. No, this is your story, and you are not being given the credit for it. This is another exploitation. Why byline नहीं दिया जाएगा? नहीं कभी कभी ऐसा होता है ना कि टीम वर्क हो जाता है आपका स्टोरी को कोई फर्दर इम्प्रूव करेगा आई हैव सीन मेनी टाइम्स देयर आर मेनी कंट्रीब्यूटर्स ये तो एक बार हो सकता है बार बार तो नहीं हो सकता है ना ऐसे हुआ है that's what I'm saying you know that it may be under pressure कि बायलाइन नहीं दिया जाए तो I mean that's a kind of aberration you know you must protest or whatsoever whosoever in this case maybe ऐसे mean mindedness तो नहीं होना चाहिए anything else yes ये तो आप बताओगे कि क्या दूरदर्शन न्यूज को कैसे लगता है आपको आपको ठीक लगता है देखो आई एम द वर्स्ट सफरर ऑफ यू नो आई टेल यू एन एग्जांपल अब बैठो आराम से बैठो ना ऐसी कोई ये नहीं है कि रेडियो में ज्यादा हमारा एक प्रॉब्लम होता था कि हमारा 2 बजे का प्राइम टाइम बुलेटिन है तो बुलेटिन से पहले कैबिनेट मीटिंग वेडनेसडे को होता था अभी भी शायद वेडनेसडे में ही होता है तो मानो 1 बजे सारे पीटीआई फ्लैश कर रहे हैं कि ये है मेन न्यूज लेकिन हम उसको नहीं दे सकते हैं हमें आएगा प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो की कंफर्मेशन आएगा तभी मैं 2 बजे की बुलेटिन में उसको ले सकती हूँ ये हमारे सामने बहुत बड़ा डिलेमा आ जाता है कि जब प्राइवेट मीडिया कर रहे हैं हम क्यों नहीं ले सकते हम तो पीछे चले जाएंगे बाकी तो सारे चैनल सब एवरीबडी सेइंग दिस इज हैपनिंग वेयर दे आर इज साइलेंट लेकिन मैं एक दो बार ऐसे किया है कि चलो कर देते हैं पीटीआई कोर्ट करके फिर हमारे जो कलीग जो प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन की जो प्रिंसिपल डीजी है वो बोलेगा अरे भाई आप कैसे कर दिया मैंने अभी तक कंफर्मेशन इशू नहीं किया आप ऐसे मत करो अगर कोई गड़बड़ हो जाएगा तो फिर नेक्स्ट टाइम बोला अच्छा ठीक है चलो हमने कहा तो पीटीआई कोर्ट कर दिया है ना तो दिस इज द क्रेडिबिलिटी हम जब तक यू नो और हम बोलते हैं कि हम एक्यूरेट है हम बैलेंस्ड है हम क्रेडिबल है क्योंकि और चैनल कुछ कह दिया बाद में सॉरी कह देगा This is the now liberty given to either All India Radio or Doordarshan. आपको confirm news ही present करना है। तो और सरकारी program तो हमें broadcast telecast करना ही है। So that is the difference between private media and Doordarshan. But you know, being the public service broadcaster, the way it promotes the development issues, which is of no importance to private media. इसकी भी तो ज़रूरत है ना? मतलब पूरा करके मत करो आई मीन गुड और बैड बोथ साइड्स
मैम आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क कि हम मीडिया को फोर्थ पिलर बोलते हैं सोसाइटी का आफ्टर जुडिशियरी एग्जीक्यूटिव एंड द
हम नहीं करते पूरा दुनिया कहते हैं
पूरा दुनिया कहते हैं बट अगर हम कहीं ना कहीं एक प्रोस्पेक्ट में देखें इंडियन कंटेंट के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में तो मैक्सिमम चैनल जो है वो आजकल पॉलिटिकल ओन्ड है और हम ये कहते हैं कि मीडिया को बायस नहीं होना चाहिए बट वो कहीं ना कहीं उस पॉलिटिकल प्रेशर की वजह से उस पॉलिटिकल सपोर्ट की वजह से बायस्ड होता है तो उसको ओवरकम कैसे किया जाए अगर आपको अपने से कुछ करना है
ये तो सबसे ज्यादा बीमारी है कि हम बायस्ड हो जाते हैं क्यों हम बायस्ड होता है क्यों हम इंडिपेंडेंटली व्यू नहीं देते हैं हमें क्या करना है हमें रूलिंग पार्टी की फेवर चाहिए अगर रूलिंग पार्टी की फेवर चाहिए कि तभी तो हम उनकी स्टोरी फाइल उनकी उनके व्यू पॉइंट प्रोजेक्ट करें ना तो मीडिया को तो ऐसा नहीं करना चाहिए ना ये पीजी वर्गीस तो ऐसा नहीं किया था ना उन्होंने प्रसार भारती के ऐसे मॉडल दिया था कि जो देख के मिस्टर वाधवानी ने कहा था कि नो इट कैन नॉट बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड उन्होंने कहा कि ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल सेफगार्ड्स होगा जैसे लेजिस्लेशन की सेफ गार्ड है जैसे जुडिशियरी की है वैसा ही हो लेकिन हुआ ही नहीं
तो सेफ गार्ड होने के बावजूद भी जर्नलिस्ट आर थ्रेटेड एवरी डे
जर्नलिस्ट आर
थ्रेटेड एवरी डे
दे आर थ्रेटेड हां वो तो होगा बिकॉज़ यू आर फॉर द ट्रुथ नथिंग बट द ट्रुथ अगर वो होगा आपके पास सामने तो चैलेंज आएगा ही आएगा तो आप चैलेंज में काउ डाउन हो जाओगे कि नहीं हमें करना है इट डिपेंड्स ऑन यू इट डिपेंड्स ऑन योर ग्रूमिंग हाउ मच यू आर ग्रूम्ड इन एथिकल बिहेवियर सो दैट इज द क्वेश्चन आई विल से यू हैव टू ओवरकम ऑल योर प्रेशर्स थैंक यू
मुझे लगता है कि जो इंग्लिश डेली है वो एडिटोरियल वाली से ज्यादा टारगेट है जैसे हिंदी डेली की. जैसे आज का एक मैंने रिपोर्ट पढ़ी थी कन्हैया कुमार की, तो इंग्लिश डेली और हिंदी डेली दोनों में पढ़ी. हिंदी डेली में उसको ज्यादा अच्छी तरह से कवरेज मिली थी और उसके बारे में बहुत डीप थी, अच्छे से एक्सप्लेन
किया,
पर इंग्लिश डेली में बहुत वीक तरीके से उसे बताया गया था. और वन क्वार्टर की बस न्यूज थी, एक क्वार्टर का जगह मिली थी उसे फ्रंट पेज, और उसी पेज में एक बहुत बड़ा एडवर्टाइजमेंट भी था. और हिंदी डेली में फ्रंट क्वार्टर, दूसरे पेज में पूरी खबर और भी कुछ खबरें हैं. तो मतलब ये इंग्लिश, ये कुछ ऐसा है कि हम यूथ ज्यादा इंग्लिश से टारगेट, तो वो हमें टारगेट कर रहे हैं, हमें इतनी अच्छी न्यूज नहीं दे रहे हैं. तो हिंदी वाले में मिलता है क्योंकि ज्यादा एल्डर लोग उसे प्रेफर करते हैं, वी प्रेफर द इंग्लिश.
ये तो हमारी मेंटेलिटी है.
नो, आई हैव आस्क्ड मेनी पीपल अबाउट इट, और मतलब ये यूथ आर प्रेफरिंग इंग्लिश न्यूज पेपर, और उसमें बहुत मेन खबरें आती हैं. ये डेली दो तीन डेली इंग्लिश डेली की बारे में साथ, और वही हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स ऑफ कॉर्स, उसमें एक छोटा सा कॉलम, इतनी बड़ी न्यूज. और ये बहुत सारे अलग अलग प्रोमिनेंट यूजर्स से हुआ है, मैंने देखा है. हिंदी में ज्यादा कवरेज नहीं है.
चलो, इसकी जवाब तो ये है कि कौन रन कर रहा है मीडिया हाउस, इनकी प्रायोरिटी क्या है, इनको एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स की ज्यादा जरूरी है. तो इसीलिए ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द न्यूज, एक न्यूज को आप कैसे ट्रीट करोगे.
सिंस कन्हैया कुमार के बारे में और आज की कल की खबरें आज अभी हुई है फॉरम में, सो विद परमिशन ऑफ अर्चना जी, आई वांट टू से टू थ्री थिंग्स व्हिच हैव बीन स्ट्राइकिंग माय माइंड सिंस मॉर्निंग. प्रॉब्लम मीडिया हाउसेस की ओनरशिप ही नहीं है इस तरह की न्यूज में, जो कन्हैया कुमार की न्यूज है, जिसमें मीडिया हाउसेस के ओनरशिप का बड़ा इशू नहीं है. इसमें मेजर इशू है कि जर्नलिज्म का जो इग्नोरेंस है, और जो चीजों की समझ है, जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन की समझ है, जो लॉ की समझ है, वो बहुत कम है. विद ऑल ड्यू रिगार्ड टू द विजडम ऑफ द यंग जनरेशन, बट वो क्या रहा है, जो भी नई जनरेशन आ रही है वो उतनी वेल रेड है नहीं. तो यू आर नॉट एबल टू टेक द राइट काइंड ऑफ डिसीजंस. कन्हैया कुमार की जो चार्जशीट फाइल हुई है, इट्स नॉट ए बिग न्यूज, जो तुमने कहा ये क्लैरिटी होनी चाहिए, इट्स अ वेरी नॉर्मल न्यूज. अगर इसमें बिग न्यूज है तो क्या है वो वन लाइनर, एक तो शायद इंडियन एक्सप्रेस ने हेडलाइन दिया है उसमें. अगर इसमें बड़ी न्यूज है तो न्यूज बड़ी क्या है, कि सरकार को चार्जशीट, पुलिस को चार्जशीट फाइल करने में 3 साल लग गए, ये है न्यूज. न्यूज ये नहीं है कि चार्जशीट फाइल हो गई, न्यूज ये है कि दिल्ली पुलिस को चार्जशीट फाइल करने में 3 साल लग गए, ये न्यूज है. So this should be projected by the channel, this should be highlighted by the newspapers, which hardly one or two newspapers have done. This means journalism ka jo profession hai, that demands a certain level of understanding, certain level of knowledge, which is missing. Besides all other things which Archana ji talked about, ye hai basic problem, aapko khabron ki samajh nahi hai. और चार्जशीट फाइल होना भी बड़ी चीज नहीं है. इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड लॉ एज ए रिपोर्टर एंड यू आर कवरिंग इट एनी सच थिंग एज ए रिपोर्टर, द मोर इम्पोर्टेंट इज फ्रेमिंग ऑफ चार्जेस, व्हिच हैज नॉट येट हैपेंड. द ट्रायल विल बी बेस्ड ऑन फ्रेमिंग ऑफ चार्जेस, नॉट ऑन फाइलिंग द चार्जशीट. तो जो जर्नलिस्ट का जो नॉलेज लेवल है, दैट इज वन ऑफ द सीरियस प्रॉब्लम्स इन टुडेज जर्नलिज्म.
इसके भी कारण है ना, अब किसी को भी लीगल पिट मिल जाए, यू डोंट नो, लीगल पिट मिलने से थोड़ा सा तो नॉलेज होना चाहिए. और आपने जो बोले 3 साल लगा, then why 2019?
Why
2019? Why now? Why now?
But before wrapping up the session, I would like to request Ms. Manmeet Kaur to conclude the session with a vote of thanks.
So before Manmeet ma'am, we'll extend the vote of thanks. So as earlier also I made an announcement that we are going to hold the International Film Festival CIFF 2019 in April.
So the formal launch of the this film festival, wherein we are formally beginning this whole thing today. The brochure has come out, so which we decided to formally unveil in this session. So I will request some of the faculty members to bring the brochure to the dais, and also I will request all the faculty members who are present in the auditoriums and Dr. Swami to please come over, and so that we can formally announce the opening of this international film festival.